Now, there are two basic strategies for fitting images to maps. Means the geometric corrections, the errors which have been introduced geometrically can be removed due to this. First is the rectification, and second is the registration. The rectification involves finding of ground control points on the image and the and on the maps from the field. Now, we have to understand that if an image is captured by the satellite and we have a map that is already with us, and that map is having coordinates with the legend, and it's a proper map. So, but our image is not georeferenced till yet. It doesn't have latitude and longitude. Now, if we are able to find some of the points on the image taken by the satellite, which doesn't have any reference, and we are able to locate the same points on the map that we already have from the survey of India, maybe we are able to locate few points on the image as well as on the maps. We call that as rectification. Now, the links between those points have to be created that are identified on the image as well as on the map. So, registration means creating links between two images or between the image and a digital map. The map may be in an analog map, or it may be a digital map. So rectification, basically going by the definition, it's a process of geometrically correcting an image that is represented on a planar surface. And you try to understand that when an image is taken by the sensor on satellite from a distance of 800 or 900 kilometers, the Earth is spherical in shape. The curvature of the Earth will there be in the image that is being captured, but we want to represent it on a 2D surface, which may be a hard copy and analog, or in the form of a digital screen or a computer screen on which we want to see the image. That is the planar surface. So while representing a 3D image on a planar surface, rectification has to be done, which can conform to other images or conform to a map. So it is a process by which geometry of an image is made planimetric. You have to make 3D into 2D. So this rectification is required. It is also required because you need to measure the area, you need to measure distance between the two points, or you need to have the direction between two points on the imagery. It's achieved by transforming the data from one, if you want to change from one grid system to another, using a geometric transformation. This is to be done. Then the process of registration, going by the definition, it's a process of establishing mathematical relationship between addresses of pixels in an image with corresponding coordinates of those pixels on another image. The same thing that I told you, that some few points identified on the map have to be identified on the map as well, on the image have to be identified on the map as well, and which means rectification, and creating the link and generating the relation between them is known as registration. Now, coming to radiometric corrections, which can be achieved by image enhancement techniques. What is an image enhancement? Modification of an image to alter its impact to the viewer. Just like you do filtering on your on the image captured by your mobile, you run a filter and it appears to you more beautiful and more contrasting, more discriminating than the previous one. Enhancements are used to make it easier for visual interpretation and understanding of the imagery. So how you can achieve image enhancement? By contrast enhancement. You can expand the values of the contrast, as you do in any case. In while you handle any image on your mobile, you increase or decrease your the contrast of your image so as the image looks appealing to you. The density values in a scene are literally pulled apart. Those are pulled apart, the density values, and the effect is to increase visual contrast between two areas of uniform densities. Likewise, there is another technique called as linear contrast stretch. A DN in the low range, because you know that a digital image has digital numbers assigned to all the pixels. what we do is in that low range DN numbers in the original histogram is assigned to extreme black, and a value at higher end is assigned to extreme white, and the remaining pixels are distributed linearly in between. This is how you do it. These are the original values, you can say 84, and these are the stretch. You literally stretch towards this side, and you are stretching the values on this side and on this side, giving low values to the extreme black and giving high values to the extreme white. Then histogram equalization, this is another kind of an image enhancement technique. This technique groups pixels that are very dark or very bright into a few gray scales. Groups pixels that are very dark or very bright into few gray scales, and if one is trying to bring out information about data in terrain shadows where it is helpful, there are clouds in your data, histogram equalization may not be appropriate in those cases where in your data there are terrain shadows. There are shadows due to mountains on the other side where on the other side of the sun, and there are clouds in your data, so histogram equalization is not going to work in that case. Another image enhancement technique is filtering is you pass some values and you enhance some values. Pixel value is modified based on the value surrounding it. Now you have a pixel value in between the middle pixel value, say you modify the value of these pixels based on the surrounding pixels, means suppressing or de-emphasizing certain frequencies. We suppress certain frequency and we pass other frequencies. We run a filter on this, that this pixel should be modified based on the average value of the pixels that are surrounding it. Likewise, this pixel will, the values of this pixel will be changed based on the average value of the pixel surrounding it, and likewise every pixel will have some changed values based on the filter that we apply. Ultimately, what the filtering is going to do, it's used for enhancing certain features, for removal of noise, and for smoothening of image. Now there is another technique for image enhancement, which is called as image fusion. We know that most of the sensors, they have a black and white, a panchromatic image, which has a high spatial resolution. It is black and white. It has it is monospectral. It doesn't have high spectral resolution. It has a very low spectral. That is only one spectral resolution, but it has a high spatial resolution. On the other hand, we have multispectral data, which has all the colors because of different, it's a multicolor because of having different image taken in different wavelengths. It has only one wavelength band, it has different wavelength bands, but here the spatial wavelength is small, here the spatial wavelength is high. So what we do is there's a technique called as fusion. We get the good out of this and the good out of this. Ultimately, we have a better image. We get spatial resolution from panchromatic image, and we get spectral resolution from multi-temporal image. The product that we get has a high resolution, having the characteristic of panchromatic resolution, and it is also multi-spectral, having multiple spectral bands corresponding to the spectral bands from the previous image. So this is how now this image can be used for many kinds of analysis that require you to have high spatial resolution as well as high spectral resolution.